I also saw in the collections that you had borrowed Basquiat to the Guggenheim.
Yes. Yes, absolutely. We, as you know, in Louvre Abu Dhabi, the artwork that you see in the galleries come from various sources. The main source is, of course, the French museums, and among the French museums, the Louvre. So more than half of the artwork that you would see in the galleries come from 13 French museums. So this is really the DNA of course, the agreement between France and the UAE for Louvre Abu Dhabi. The other half is composed of artworks from Louvre Abu Dhabi collection and regional loans. When we say regional, we mean artworks from the UAE, you may have seen very early the pendentif from Ras Al Khaimah, Dubai. So we're working with our partner within the UAE. We have this incredible loan from Jordan, from Al Razain. We are working with Saudi, KSA. We're working with Oman, but we're also working within Abu Dhabi Emirate with our colleagues, and we are working. We have loans from the Zayed National Museums and the Guggenheim Abu Dhabi, two museums which don't exist yet. You can see the work.
What can we expect from the Guggenheim? Do you have any new?
I don't have the exact date, but I know it's moving. I know it's progressing. I know. If you come on Saadiyat, it's a teaser for your listener. If you come on Saadiyat, you would pass close to the Jacques Chirac Avenue, you would see the Zayed National Museum, which is really, really visible now out of the ground. And I don't have the exact calendar, but I know it's progressing a lot.
And who is the architect?
Foster.
Ah oui. Okay.
So you have Foster, Zayed National Museum, Gary for the Guggenheim Abu Dhabi, and Jean Nouvel for the Louvre Abu Dhabi. Louvre Abu Dhabi, of course, opened since 2017, and Guggenheim again starting to progress. So these museums don't exist as a site, as an open thing, but they exist as a team which is already working, and they exist as the beginning of a collection.
So for us, they have, you know what they have in their collection?
Yes, yes, yes. We talk to them. They are our colleagues, our friends. We so for us, it's not the first loan we got from the Guggenheim Abu Dhabi collection. Huh?
And what about what are you doing with the Saudi?
Saudi, we had several ways of collaborating. The most important one was the routes of Arabia, les routes d'Arabie, which was a very impressive venue of the exhibition. So you remember the story. The exhibition was invented.
Now
we still have open loans. So we have the rock art in the entrance. What you see in the very entrance of Louvre Abu Dhabi today, just before entering into the galleries, you see the Cy Twombly from Louvre Abu Dhabi collection, and in co-visibility with the rock art from the Riyadh Museum, from our colleagues. So it's an extended loan that was generated at the moment of the exhibition Route d'Arabie, and we have kept it because it's very powerful to have this.
I think it's one of the masterpieces of the installation. I mean, the dialogue between Twombly and that is wow.
Thanks. And absolutely. And when you enter into a museum or into an exhibition, the first thing you see is giving a little bit the tempo
or yes.
Manifestation. And this works very well. So this is why we kept it. We're very pleased that they have extended the loans. We have.
Do you have as a project with them?
Yeah, we have other. We're in discussion always talking to them.
About the Lula?
No, Alula is another project of development of a full region of the kingdom, if I'm not mistaken. So we have received the teams of Alula guides. We have shared. So we had some exchange. We know them. But as a museum, we are working with other museums. So the natural entry point for us into the Saudi system is the Commission for Culture and Heritage.
So I'm obliged to ask the question again about Leonardo, but I think you have nothing to say.
Yeah, you said it. I can invite you to talk to
And so your budget of acquisition is still the same?
Yes.
I don't remember the amount, but it's official, right?
There are things you can never buy, and there are things you can cleverly buy, and there are Louvre Abu Dhabi is about hybridity. So we are building this strong collection, which is driven by a narrative. So we're not in the exhaustivity approach, but we need to be able to tell the story. Then we have the access to the French collection, which is a big plus. And we have sometimes this kind of friendship with closed museums or regional museums or
but
international.
To be precise about the budget of acquisition, you can speak about it, right?
I can speak, but we don't like to we don't like to overemphasize. It's also a very difficult year for everybody, budgetarily speaking. So what I know is that the commitments are from the government to keep the momentum on the growth of the collection. The here the direction is quite clear. It is about more and more artworks have to be from Louvre Abu Dhabi collection and less from the French. So here we are preparing the not autonomy, but the critical mass of the Louvre Abu Dhabi with this collection to tell this story.
It's when shall it stop with the
normally,
French museum?
Normally it's 10 years from the opening.
So in
we, are in the third... 7 years? Sorry?
In 7 years, it has to stop.
Six, it would be closer to six. But I don't know if you remember the agreement. It's 300, 250, 200. So normally there is an. So it's a huge energy to make sure that we can follow the steps of the decrescendo of the French loans. And so this is less obvious for the visitors, because we don't say this coming from France, this coming from the Louvre Abu Dhabi collection. But for us, it's a very important mobilization of the effort, curatorial effort, acquisition effort to get this autonomy.